China is calling on the removal of the BRP Sierra Madre. I'd like to get your thoughts on this and also on the bill. What do you think we should do regarding at additional outposts on our waters?
So you have two loaded questions. One, China, as I've said yesterday, cannot, should not, is not allowed to veto our Philippine Maritime Zones Law. The Philippine Maritime Zones Law, by encapsulating the arbitral ruling, would really strengthen our hold in the Second Thomas Shoal or the Ayungin Shoal, where the BRP Sierra Madre is located. China cannot dictate upon us to remove that. That is still a commissioned vessel. China cannot even tow that away from that area. It is ours. Second, as regards the enhancement of other outposts, I totally agree that we have to do that. Not just in the West Philippine Sea area, but in the Philippine Rice or Talampas ng Pilipinas area. And I have been, modesty aside, personally involved in discussions on how this can be done soonest. And there are lots of innovations and structures in place right now, which would really show that the Philippine Navy, the Philippine Coast Guard has done a lot. And I commend the leadership of both organizations for being very proactive in this.
And all, and finally, before we go, Senator, on a different topic, I just want to get to your reaction on the passage of the House version of the bill seeking to amend the economic provisions of the Philippine Constitution. How are discussions faring in the Senate?
I attended the tail end of the last hearing concerning education. So it's still moving forward. The subcommittee of Senator Angara is it's still moving. So I'm not privy to what transpired yesterday in the House Committee of the Whole as regards RB 87. And 2 days ago, I filed Resolution 941. Resolution 941 is a first in terms of the Senate rules. It would now produce a methodology, a process of how the Constitution can be amended, utilizing the RB 86 when it comes to the plenary. So it's now my proposal is now under discussion by the Senate Committee on Rules. It is the only, modesty aside again, it's the only supplement to the existing Senate rules that would allow the amendment of the Constitution via a fourth mode. Which has been espoused by our former dean, the Ateneo Law School, Father Bernas, as to how to amend the Constitution, voting separately. And I hope the Senate Rules Committee would have this approved pretty soon to really show that the Senate is moving forward likewise, similar to what the lower house is doing.
Well, do you think you have the numbers? Enough to pass RBH6.
I cannot answer that. Let's leave that to the Senate leadership. I'm just one vote. I'm just a constitutional law junkie trying to contribute something to the refinement of what seems to be what appears to be gaps in our constitution right now.
All right, with that, I'll let you go. Thank you so much, Senator, for
Thank
your
you.
time.
Good
You have a
morning.
good
Good morning,
morning.
Rica, and give my regards to Ms. Karen Davila as well. Have a
Thank you.
nice
We'll do
day.
that. Thank you, Senator Francis Tolentino, joining us on Hot Copy.